Hello friends, this is Banu from Stuff You Look blog. Well, I'm back with a video tutorial, and in this video I'm gonna share as well as give some of my ideas regarding what not to be done in sketching, what mistakes people that you people usually do while attempting sketch was both during practice as well as during exams. Well, I remember I told you the importance of sketching and the role of sketching work in CEED exam. So it's important that you should be bothering much about that, and now is the right time to go through the mistakes as well as learn some what could be done and what could be avoided so as to make your practice a big success. Well, in this video tutorial, I'm going to assume myself as an examiner, and I would be giving my views as well as share my views for some carefully chosen pictures that I received last year from some of the students as well as from my friends for their feedback. Well, I hope you had a great weekend, and I too had a great weekend, and I was working lately with my own projects. That's why I couldn't make any posts or videos lately, and fortunately this week I could spare some time for you, I mean for the posts as well as videos, and that's it. Let's look into the pictures and let's learn what are the mistakes that people usually do. Okay, I mean with this sketch. Actually, last year I posted some design questions for everyday practice for the aspirants, CEED aspirants, and I got good response from many the aspirants as well as my friends. They made the sketches and shared with me, and this is one of the sketches that I received from one of my friend, and I was glad that the sketch was somewhat good, and although I expected some kind of changes to be made. See, the first and foremost change that I expected was this pipe. But this vent pipe is not looking like pipe, it was looking just like a cloth or some kind of towel, right? So this could have been shown somewhat in a straight position or in a parallel lines, so that it would have appeared practical. And I'm also not satisfied with this kind of sink. This sink was more or less like a rectangular shape, and I don't think any sink, I mean that practical sinks in bathrooms could be of this shape. This could have been shown somewhat like the elliptical manner like we saw in regular household bathrooms, right? And this towel was also not appropriate, I think so. This could have been somewhat better. And the next concern was this circular vent hole for the exhaust system. Actually, you can see the wall was some kind of slant in nature, so that the viewer was viewing from the front. So this circle should not be exactly in circular shape. This could have been somewhat elliptical shape. This could have been shown somewhat in elliptical shape. And I also expect some kind of projection in the back side of this wall, so that whenever someone looks into it, we can get the feel that thickness of this wall. And next comes this stub part. This stub was comparatively smaller in size as compared to this geyser as well as the sink. This could have been somewhat larger in shape. And rest things were fine. She drew everything well. She also gave some good shadings. She included some technical and detailing works, and everything was just fine. I really appreciate the work. The next picture was, this was my favorite picture of all time. I can say I can judge the perfectness in this picture, although the picture quality was not good because of the poor capture of the camera. I was quite happy with this kind of picture because everything is in correct nature. I mean perception, size, as well as the shape, as well as the view was a perfect sketch, I can say. So I was really happy. This was the sketch shared by one of my friend. Her name was Suchi. And I really appreciate the way she sketched this chair. This was a perfect aesthetic chair. And I just hoped for one small change. She could have shown everything with some thickness included, like some kind of double lines here, so that this sketch would appear as a practical through sketch, right? Even she showed this desk and everything in a single straight line manner. This could have shown some kind of some thickness could have been included. Other than that, I don't think there is any mistake. She also shown every part of this with perfect size and perfect what you called shading factor. Shading was of course light, but it was really acceptable and really appreciable, I guess. Okay, let's get into the next question. This was also a picture shared by some other friend of mine, and this was the sketch in response to the question of the CEED previous paper. The question goes like this: you have to sketch the view of a basket full of fruits with giving details to the fruits. And yes, the sketch was good, and she prepared a basket very well. She also designed it with some kind of details. She gave the handle some kind of good detailing. Everything was just fine, but I was just wondering, is it exactly required to show this much big size of table with all the legs included? I don't think it's important, because the question asks you to sketch the view of the basket with fruits only. And why is it required to sketch all this unnecessary stuff? See, she also showed some walls or home. It just looked like you are watching a room instead of watching a basket. So I would appreciate her if she has showed some kind of this much part of the sketch. I mean, some kind of zoomed view, right? So that she avoiding all the rest part, like this table and legs, and these are all unnecessary parts. It also consumes time, right? So you could avoid that, and you could just go through the part what they particularly asked. You just concentrate on that part and leave the rest part. It's not necessary to sketch all those things. And the remaining things are very fine. She also gave some great details to the fruits, and everything was just fine. The next question was more or less to the same previous question from the CEED paper, and this was the attempt from my other friend. He attempted this very well, and he gave less importance to the background, and he also trimmed the parts without giving much details to the table, and like the earlier girl did. And the basket was also good, some kind of design he showed, and the fruits were very good. He gave some great details to it. And yes, one small note that I wish to bring to you. This, you can see the length of this table was shown, some I think 2 inches or something. And if that is a 2 inches, then we can assume that the table has been watched from the top. I mean, more or less from the top of the, by in a standing position, you can say. Standing position. If that is the case, then this basket should also be in open, I mean more open position, like this edge you are seeing, right? This edge could be somewhat like this. Yes, so that the both this table as well as the basket will be in same perception, I mean same position or perception. That could have been better. Other than that, I don't think there is any mistake in this sketch. Okay, yeah, this was the excellent sketch from my friend. His name was Manish Khatri, and he drew it very well. I really appreciate the work he did. He gave everything he showed everything in a perfect manner, the size and shadings, details, as well as the perception, and everything was just fine. Even the loop of bread was shown excellently. I was really happy with this kind of picture, but unfortunately, I think he didn't got selected last year in CEED exam. I don't know why, but it was really unfortunate. I was really sad for that, and I really was upset with the kind of a selection procedure that these institutes were taking. Those kinds of intelligent people were lacking behind. They are left behind with no opportunities. I really feel pity for such kind of situations. Sketch I received from a friend, and in response to the CEED previous paper, he attempted this, and the question was to sketch the view of a candle with a matchbox and some matchsticks patterned on on the ground or table, you can say. So this was a good attempt, somewhat good attempt, but I was not satisfied with the size factor. Actually, the picture could have been somewhat taken care in terms of size. See, the matchbox was looking in more or less like, I can say, 2.5 inches in length. And the matchstick that was patterned in ground was not equal to the length. I mean, this size was less than an inch, right? So, actually, it was not practical. Actually, it should be the of same size as compared to the length of the matchbox. And the first and foremost view that I get after watching this was the size factor. And other than that, he gave some good details. And he also showed some kind of shadow to this candle as well as the matchbox. And I really appreciate him if you would have shown this candle in a bigger size and also in a thick, I mean, less thickness compared to this matchbox. And other than that, everything was fine. And I just want you to tell that you should be caring about the size factor. Size is most important part in his sketch. You should be caring much about it. And instead of showing this all kind of what you called shading and other stuff, you could bother more on size. So it will give practical approach. It will look like a practical sketch. So be concerned more on the size as well as the proportion as well as the perception instead of the shadings, everything, right? Okay, let's look into the next picture. Yeah, this was a sketch I received last year, I guess. Okay, and this was in response to the question that I posted in my everyday design practice part. And she made this sketch very well. She gave some kind of details as well as the what you call texture to this table. I really appreciate the work. It was very fine work. And the rest parts like the what you call the proportion as well as the details for this human were also good. And I really wanted to check, is this big kind of books really available? I don't think this this much big is required to be shown, because you just compare this book size with the size of the dustbin provided below, right? So you can see these books are appearing more in size than compared to the what you call the dustbins as well as the rest part of the sketch. So I would really appreciate her if she could have shown that smaller in size compared to the rest part. And other than that, yeah, one more. This line is lacking in terms of perception, because this line, you can see these lines are approaching in this direction, moving to the left part, right? So this should also be in the same, something like this direction. Then only the picture will assume the in same real time perception. So she just drew it in this direction and it went wrong, I guess. And other than that, she also gave some nice details. She included some accessories and she drew the desktop very fine. And everything was just fine. She could just concern about this size, right? Yeah, this was the answer for the same question, previous question, but from some other friend. His name was Varun. Yeah, Varun. And this was a very nice attempt. Everything was a perfect position. Perception was also very fine. He also gave some good shadings, little shadings, but that is very fine for the picture. And I really appreciate the what you call the proportion as well as the size factor of the human as well as the chair. And the details that he has given to this picture was really appreciable. I really had to say hats off to this picture. And I don't think there is any mistake in this sketch except for the face of this human. Okay, that's not a big issue in such a big sketch. It's not a big issue to bother about this face. And the rest parts are really very, very fine. Yeah, this was a picture that one of my friend drew very randomly by looking into some picture or something, I guess. I don't know. This was just fine. And I have to say that she missed the concept of vanishing point. you might have known about the vanishing point in perception sketch, right? Perception vanishing point is one important point that every line in the sketch, in the view or a photograph meets at the point. Say this line is moving like this, right? And this line, this edge is also in, if you extend this edge, this will also go here and go and meet this line somewhere here. Okay, so same goes with this line and this line. So every sketch as well as every photography will appear in such type of vanishing points. It might be one vanishing point, two, three, depending on the view you are looking. So these were supposed to be in the same vanishing point, but she actually did a mistake with this thing, I mean table. She made this sketch, I mean the edge of this table in somewhat slant direction, that when you extend this will go and meet somewhere here, but this line when extended should meet somewhere here, right? So I guess the sketch should be somewhat like this direction, right? So other than that, I don't think there is any mistake. She gave some good details to the windows, also shown some scenery, as well as she gave some lights with effects, and she also included some accessories. Yeah, this table I really bothered. Is that really practically feasible to design such kind of table? I don't know. You just have to imagine. But I think it can be, it could be possible if it were this length, I mean this length were shown some kind of slant or bent in position. Maybe in that way this chair could be possible. Other than that, I don't think this legged shape chair, L-shaped chair, is practically not possible. And yeah, everything else was just fine. Well, this was the picture that one of my friends sent me, and this was in response to a storyboard making and the story of a tiger that encroached into the human village or something like that. And you can see how childish this picture was. Just watch this human as well as this tiger, some kind of grass, houses. These were just like some kind of children. Children do this when they were some 10, in the age of 10 or something. But do you really think this is not good? Actually, it's really good because, say if you have watched the previous CEED paper, I mean CEED 2014 paper, you might have seen the question that asked to frame a storyboard consisting of 20 frames. You heard that? 20 frames. And it's really tough for you to sketch 20 frames in just half an hour, or I can say to 40 minutes that you can, that you will be getting. So it's really difficult for you, and I can say it's really impossible for you to sketch and give all the details to every frame. And I can say this kind of little detailed frames are very, works very fine in that situations, right? So don't think this is not absolutely fine. This is absolutely fine, and you can just go for it. Yes, you can see everything was simply shown. The what the narrator want to express were shown clearly. See, this human were running, watching, seeing this tiger, and this juvenile taking this, what you call it, cage along with this. So it's very important that you just need to express the story, express the story that you framed in order to make the storyboard meaningful. And it's I think it's not very important on how you create these characters, how do you drew this what you call surroundings and everything. So you just concentrate on the story, you just make some simple line sketches, especially in 2D, two-dimensional sketches. That's very acceptable, and it's I can say it's very appropriate to show, because in that very little time span, like I said earlier, you won't be doing this all this stuff. So you just don't think that this is some kind of childish or some kind of children's like 10 years age people do, it's really practical. You just go on. You can observe in Tinkle or some other books also how this kind of storyboards appear, in what way they express this story. So you just need to realize that this story is important, and it's not the diagram in this kind of situations. I mean, in case of comic strips as well as in storyboard, and the rest parts like design, product designs and everything, you should be caring about the product sketches also. Okay, so just go for this. It's not a fault. Just go for it. The next sketch I received this in response to my question from the design attitude daily exercise. And this was the sketch of a wheelchair with multi-purpose use, and the sketch was done by one of my friends. She gave very good details. She also included the size factor. She considered about the size factor, shapes, and she also shown some kind of explanations to her work, and she included some kind of technical words. Everything was just fine. I really have to appreciate the way, including the perception is also fine. And yes, one small mistake. She drew this circle, I mean this wheel, in a inappropriate way, right? So this should be in conjunction with this wheelchair, and this could have shown some kind of this elliptical shape, and this was also a kind of perfect circular shape. So whenever someone looks, it assumes like the wheels were just kept on the floor, right? So other than that, I don't think there is any mistake in the sketch. There is no, I mean, very little shading works, but that's absolutely fine. That's no wrong actually. Yeah, this was also the sketch that I received from the same friend earlier, and this was the solutions to our to the question that I posted in my design question regarding multi-purpose, waste dustbin that could be provided in the street, I mean roadside streets. And I am very happy that this question, as it is, appeared in the CEED previous paper. I am really glad. I am feeling really honored to say that one of my practice exercise really appeared in CEED paper. Okay, right. This attempt was fine. She just simply showed or expressed her idea with some kind of explanations and everything. But the thing was, you have to take it for granted that this type of questions will be asked for not less than 15 marks, right? So say last year, if you checked the question paper marks, then this question appeared for 50 marks. You heard that, 50 marks. And you can't be showing this kind of line diagrams for 50 marks. You should be giving some kind of details, some kind of explanations. Okay, I appreciate that she showed some explanation, but this sketch could have been shown some kind of details, like this line, excuse me. Okay, this line, what she showed was looking like a thin paper or a sheet, but in actually this could have been made in double parallel lines, right? So that it will appear some kind of practical way. And the rest parts ideas were good, and she also included some kind of buttons to open respective waste box to dump waste. Everything was just fine. And if she wants to include this kind of button, then she should also show some kind of thickness, as well as some kind of the approach, I mean the procedure, and how it will work, how the buttons work in conjunction with this waste dustbin. So just keep the marks factor, how much marks it will bring you. And and if say it's 50 marks, then you have to put all your effort. You have to show the all the rough sketches, as well as with a detailed sketch with all the details, as well as explanations, factors included. And if it's say for just 10 or 15 marks, then you still have to show some kind of details, but with less explanation, as well as less shadings or something like that. You should be able to spare almost all the time for that, right? Okay, next picture was an excellent, I can say, attempt from one the friend, my previous friend Varun. He made this from one of his, he designed this from a waste shoebox, and and with all the accessories like waste cardboards and everything. And this idea he just included for the sake of daily usage without wasting the waste, I mean shoebox. Well, the sketch went well. He gave very good idea. He included very good idea. He gave very good explanations, as well as he shown everything, toolboxes and everything fine. And he made the sketch with some compartments so that different kinds of stuff will be could be accommodated. And he also, I have to appreciate him. He showed some kind of electrical installation here. You can see charging ports, as well as the torch system, LEDs, and the speaker systems with the chargeable ports. And the idea was very good, except for the fact I was really bothered about this lid. I mean the box closing lid. If this were provided, and this were supposed to be close up shoebox, right? And if such kind of standing toolbox and tools were there, accessories were there, then you cannot close this thing, right? Then instead, Mr. Varun could have shown this in cut position or open position or some kind of holes included, so that whenever he wants to close this, then this will appear on the top. Or else, the best thing is he could have removed this thing. He could have eliminated sketching this whole thing. I mean this lid thing. Then this sketch would have appeared very fine. Other than that, I don't think there is any mistake in this sketch. It's very good. The idea is also very appreciable. The next sketch was also from one of my friend, other friend. And this is in response to a question. This question was posted by me in my design practice problem identification section. And I just wanted the viewers to identify the problems related to this ATM location center. Problems related to humans interface, as well as the usability, as well as approachability and everything. So and my friend did this. And he gave some kind of good stuff, included some kind of good stuff. He also shown some technical things and really appreciate the way. But I have to say that this sketch went totally wrong. Yes, this I have to say I will give only one mark for say 20 marks question, because I expect you people to analyze this scenario and relate the problems related to this in a particular scenario. I mean this kind of picture, and I'm not bothered about what is inside the ATM center or something like that. So you have to check this picture, and you have to see how you need to provide comfort to this human, and how you need to cater the needs of the question requirements. And you should forget the remaining things, rest things like the inside of ATM or this lane next to this or some kind of these people. This is not at all required. You just need to concentrate on the fact what they asked, what they required you to do. So for this kind of questions, you just go on doing things. I mean, just attempt what they asked, and you just neglect the remaining rest things. Okay. Well, that's how I ended this section, and I am glad I gave some inputs through some tips, as well as by taking some sketches. And I am really happy that my friends shared these sketches with them. And you know, mistaking really rocks. You need to attempt some mistakes so as to make you learn, so as to step further. And never feel that you did mistake, and mistaking is a bad thing. Mistaking is always rocks. And yes, you can get more from my blog stuffyoulook.blogspot.com regarding resources, answers to previous papers, creativity, design mistakes and everything. And that's for it. That's for today. And I'm glad I gave some inputs. And thanks for watching my video. And I hope I have to sign off now. Now, take care. Bye.